Welcome to HIV Community Link online e-learning presentation on pre-exposure prophylaxis, a new HIV prevention option. So what is PrEP? PrEP, or Truvada, is an approved HIV treatment medication that has been recommended for use in non-HIV positive individuals to prevent them from acquiring HIV. This particular medication is known as tenofovir disoproxil fumarate, or by its trademark name, Truvada. Truvada, developed by Gilead Sciences, is a fixed-dose combination of two antiretroviral drugs used for the treatment of HIV and consists of 300 mg of tenofovir disoproxil fumarate, of which 245 mg is tenofovir, also known as Vireid, and 200 mg of entricitabine, also known as Emtriva. Truvada is a prescription medication that is used in two different ways: to treat HIV-1 infection in adults and teenagers 12 years of age and older, and when used as treatment for HIV infection, Truvada is always used in combination or together with other HIV-1 medicines. It is also used to help reduce the risk of getting HIV-1 infection when used together with safer sex practices. This use is only for adults who are at high risk of getting HIV-1. This includes HIV-negative men who have sex with men and who are at high risk of getting infected with HIV-1 through sexual practices, and for male-female sex partners when one partner is HIV-positive and the other is not. This is also known as a serodiscordant relationship. Truvada does not cure HIV-1 infection. Always practice safer sex and use condoms to lower the chances of sexual contact with body fluids. Never reuse or share needles or other items that may have body fluids on them or have been used by another individual. So what about approval and recommendations? Truvada was originally approved for HIV treatment by the US FDA in 2004. 2 years later, Health Canada approved Truvada as an HIV treatment for Canadians to access. There have been a number of clinical trials and studies conducted with limited and previously known side effects identified by some participants. I will speak to those studies shortly. In 2012, the US FDA approved Truvada as a prevention option for persons not living with HIV to consider using as an additional option to prevent becoming infected with HIV, including the recommendation that regular condom use remain part of those individual behaviors. In 2014, the US CDC made their recommendation on who could benefit from Truvada as a prevention option for persons not living with HIV to consider to further reduce their risk of infection. These recommendations also included guidelines for the prescribing, use, and follow-up care required for anyone taking Truvada as PrEP by their healthcare providers. In 2014, the World Health Organization, or WHO, provided their similar recommendations and guidelines on who could benefit from Truvada as a prevention option for negative persons, including and updating guidelines clarifications released in July of 2014. So who is PrEP being recommended for? Key populations identified are men who have sex with men, persons who may be in prison, persons who use injection or other substances that involve injection drug use, persons who may be involved in sex work, and transgender individuals. Although certain at-risk populations were identified in PrEP recommendations and guidelines, there are other individuals who could also benefit, but may not fit into this previously mentioned five populations. There are heterosexual individuals that also meet the same risk profiles as men who have sex with men who could benefit from access to PrEP. Women could greatly benefit, especially if they may be living in situations where condom negotiation is difficult or impossible, condoms and other barriers are not available, or if there is sexual violence in the relationship, and if accessible, it could be the most confidential option for women to consider to protect themselves from HIV infection. Family and pregnancy planning for serodiscordant couples could benefit with the reduced risk of transmission identified in clinical trials to date. Serodiscordant same-sex couples could also benefit from this reduced risk of transmission reality. As mentioned earlier in the presentation, there have been a number of clinical trials conducted for Truvada as PrEP. The PARTNER study found that when taken consistently, Truvada provided a 90% risk reduction in HIV transmissions among heterosexual men and women in serodiscordant relationships, where one person is positive and the other person is negative. The IPREX study found that when taken consistently, Truvada provided a 92% risk reduction in HIV transmissions among men who had sex with men. Further analysis estimated 99% protection when used daily. The IPREX OLE, or Open Label Extension Study, found Truvada to be 96% effective in persons taking it at least 4 times per week. The TDF2 study found Truvada reduced the risk of HIV infection by up to 78%. Low adherence was linked to the lower effectiveness in HIV infections. The PROUD study in the UK has just moved to end the placebo arm of their trial with gay and MSM based on overwhelming indications of its preventive effectiveness. The study will continue to gather other relevant and important data from all participants in the study. All current participants in the study are now being offered Truvada if they wish to access it. Ibergay was launched in France in January of 2012 and began in Montreal, Quebec in July of 2013. Within this framework, they will study men who take Truvada before and after having anal sex on an as-needed basis with the goal of preventing infection. They will then compare the results from previous studies that have already tested the efficacy of PrEP when taken daily. Currently, the Ibergay studies are looking to follow suit with the UK study in opening the door to allow access to Truvada for all participants in the clinical study. No decision has been made at this date. An Ontario clinical trial is set for Toronto and is being conducted and currently enrolling participants for the study. What is most clear from the research is that taking PrEP as prescribed and not skipping doses, also known as adherence, is the most important factor in how well PrEP can prevent against HIV infection. You must take the medication daily for the most effective results of PrEP. So what about accessibility? Accessibility to PrEP in Canada has a number of challenges as Truvada has not yet been approved as PrEP, although it has been approved as treatment for HIV-positive persons for more than 10 years. Because Truvada has not been approved for prevention of HIV, but has been approved for treatment of HIV, it is only accessible through an off-label prescription from a doctor. It is a very expensive medication at an average cost of $1,200 per month. Although covered by Alberta Healthcare for treating persons living with HIV infection, it is not currently covered for persons who are not infected with HIV. This leads to the individual having to pay out of pocket or have a copay option to help reduce the price through a private insurance policy. There are programs currently in place with Gilead for US residents wanting to access at a greatly reduced price below $100 per month, but none are currently available in Canada. Truvada, however, stands as what some have described as a boutique option for affluent individuals, and those most likely to benefit from access will not have the option to consider it due to its expensive costs. It is important to remember that PrEP is not a substitute for proper regular condom use. Truvada has been shown to reduce the risk of HIV transmission, but it does not prevent other sexually transmitted infections from occurring. Truvada, or PrEP, is only one part of an integrated approach to healthcare and HIV prevention and transmission. Condom messaging must remain as part of all HIV prevention and education messaging as part of a multi-option prevention strategy and behavior. AIDS service organizations, or ASOs, have a responsibility to be informed and provide that information to their clients, staff, volunteers, and the greater communities they serve. This is a great opportunity to reignite gay and MSM into their healthcare and services for getting tested for HIV and other sexually transmitted infections. Research opportunities exist in light of the clinical trials, current knowledge of Truvada as a treatment, and to create evidence-based results of Truvada as PrEP. There are a number of barriers to accessing PrEP in Canada as well as other places throughout the globe. As mentioned earlier, the cost ranges from $800 to $1,200 per month depending on where you live and what kind of healthcare coverage is in place. There is also a strong anti-PrEP campaign underway in the U.S. calling Truvada a party drug that will lead to promiscuity and lack of condom use and safer sexual behaviors. There is strong shaming and judgment coming from communities on persons considering PrEP as an option for them, including frontline services, that has led to a pro-PrEP campaign known as Truvada Whore, where people are taking the name and wearing it proudly as PrEP users and informing others of its benefits. Guidelines have been developed and released, but have not yet managed to get into the hands of frontline healthcare workers who are not yet comfortable with the new information and ongoing controversy surrounding the medication. Persons who could benefit, particularly men who have sex with men, are not aware of PrEP and have very limited and often conflicting information available to them. There are a number of benefits to consider when we are speaking to and thinking about access to PrEP. There is the additional layer of prevention and protection for both the negative and positive individual, especially for those who may be considering pregnancy and other family planning options. It could help to reduce the stigma associated with HIV if this treatment were promoted and available as an option for everyone to consider. It has been shown to reduce HIV anxiety in men who have sex with men, even when using condoms and other barriers for protection. No studies have identified any serious long-term or short-term side effects for taking Truvada as either treatment or for prevention of HIV. Persons considering PrEP as an option are more likely to have been tested for HIV and other STIs prior to starting the medication, making them aware of their current HIV and STI status. This is important, as we know that 1 in 4 Canadians who are living with HIV are not aware of their HIV status, and this could be a huge factor in the fueling of new HIV infections in Canada. Persons who are taking PrEP are connected to healthcare services and are regularly tested for HIV and other sexually transmitted infections as part of the criteria for accessing PrEP. You can only access PrEP if you are connected to a doctor and undergo the same 3-month access to care, testing, and blood and organ monitoring that an HIV-positive person on treatment goes through all their lives. PrEP can be a game changer. Dr. Deborah Brinkham, MD, and Director of the Division of Antiviral Products, as the FDA stated, "In the 80s and early 90s, HIV was viewed as a life-threatening disease. In some parts of the world, it still is. Medical advances, along with the availability of almost 30 approved individual HIV drugs, have enabled us to treat it as a chronic disease most of the time. But it is still better to prevent HIV than to treat a lifelong infection of HIV." And Dr. Rachel Bagley from the World Health Organization HIV Department stated, "Bold policies can deliver bold results." So HIV Community Link recommends education and information and consultation with key affected populations needs to happen. Professional development and continuing education for healthcare professionals also needs to begin. Dialogue and consultation with regulatory bodies, including Alberta Medical Association and the Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons, also needs to take place. Consideration needs to be given to any provincial and/or federal guidelines that may be developed to inform clinical use of PrEP, and that the development of a timely and coordinated provincial response to proven HIV prevention technologies needs to happen if we are to make change. HIV Community Link also believes that enhanced medically supervised access to PrEP in Canada needs to occur. That all individuals and communities have the right to make informed decisions and have access to evidence-based proven technologies to improve both individual and public health outcomes. Health officials, policymakers, and related service organizations have a responsibility to educate themselves and their communities about emerging issues and strategies to reduce the harms associated with HIV. And that PrEP is a new technology in the toolbox and is a complementary option to be used alongside other known and proven strategies that include access to low-barrier HIV testing, risk reduction tools such as condoms and safe injection supplies, treatment as prevention, post-exposure prophylaxis, treatment of sexually transmitted infections and ongoing behavioral, psychosocial, and structural interventions, including outreach, support services, counseling, and advocacy. We've been at it for over 30 years. HIV Community Link understands that a one-size-fits-all approach to HIV prevention does not exist, and that we look forward to continuing to assist our communities in identifying and accessing the right prevention tool at the right time, including PrEP.